Right, this movie's going to go over how to calculate consumer surplus and what happens if we have some common changes in consumer surplus. So first, consumer surplus is easily calculated by first drawing our typical graph with price and quantity, and then measuring out our demand curve. So in order to calculate consumer surplus, we need this demand curve and we need some price level. We'll call it P star. And then we need to know what this P upper limit is too, because we need these numbers in order to calculate consumer surplus. So consumer surplus is the difference between what you're willing to pay, which is how we construct this demand curve, and what you actually have to pay. So for each of these consumers, they're willing to pay a lot more than the actual price they have to pay. So it's that area between the demand curve and the price paid that's going to be our consumer surplus. And as you can see, as long as we have linear demand curves, consumer surplus is going to be a triangle. So you have to know how to calculate the area of a triangle. And if you don't, I'll tell you. It's half base times height. So let's go through an example. If we're given a curve, so we have our Q and P and our demand and our price. So what if price is 5, this upper limit price is 10, and our equilibrium quantity is 5. Okay, so our formula says half base times height. Well, what's the base here? The base goes from 0 to 5, so our base is 5. What's our height? Goes from 5 to 10, so our height is also 5. So 5 times 5 is 25. Half times 25 gives us 12.5. So our consumer surplus would be equal to 12.5. Now let's switch it up a little bit. What if we shift this demand curve? So let's say that it now intersects at 8 and price is still at 5. So this is our demand curve before 5. Let's call this 3. This is our demand curve before. For some reason it shifts left, and this is our new consumer surplus. How do we calculate the area of that? Well, it's going to be 1/2 times base 3 times height 3. So our new consumer surplus is going to be 4.5. So if they ask us to calculate the difference in consumer surplus, it's going to be 12.5 minus 4.5. What is that going to give us? 8. So really, to solve these problems, all you have to do is shift that curve, know what the values are, calculate the areas of the triangles, and then subtract one from the other to find the difference. You can also have a situation where the price increases. So if you have Q and P, let's do 10, that's our demand curve. We have a P of 5, P star, our equilibrium quantity is 5. We know what the area of that is, but now let's increase our P star star, we'll call it, to 7. We also need to know what that new quantity is going to be, so let's call it 3. If we take the area of this triangle, base is going to be 3, height's going to be 3, we get the same values before, 4.5. So again, even if they were to shift that supply curve to result in a new equilibrium price, the way you calculate the difference in consumer surplus is just calculate that the area of the triangle before and the area of the triangle after. So we know that the area of the triangle before was 12.5, area of the triangle after 4.5 gives us that 8. So whether it's demand shifting or supply shifting, all you're doing is calculating areas of triangles and then subtracting one from the other to get your difference in that consumer surplus.